tell us about your entrepreneurial journey. Everyone knows you as the race car driver, and you've been on stages speaking about that. But tell us about Chetan the entrepreneur.
Entrepreneur, I would say, I have to give credit to my parents, you know, who were really behind every success of mine. And there were a lot of things I learned from them, especially because my mother being, I would say she was an iron lady in my family, because she was ready for any challenges. And she actually taught me that, you know, if there's a challenge coming ahead, be ready to challenge it instead of running away from it. So that actually gave me a lot of motivation before I did anything, you know. So every opportunity was like a challenge for me. And I thought, okay, was this good enough? You know, am I so good to actually get something so big? But again, I was ready for it because I know nothing comes easy. I know there's a great battle behind it, and I was ready to face it.
Talk to us a little about what networking platforms like Tai mean to the entrepreneurship community. What do they have to offer? What do you gain from them? So on and so forth.
Well, firstly, I would say, you know, because for the past 1 year, I've been working with a lot of youngsters. And I kind of noticed something, that many of them really don't have a direction anymore. Well, they had a dream, they had something they wanted to achieve so much, but trust me, this hand-to-mouth situation today in India, you know, they're just trying to sustain with one kind of income, living their life and just dreaming something there. But after a point of time, they lose hopes, they forget the direction. And, you know, but I believe that, you know, opportunities are everywhere. You just need to go find it, grab it and take it, because if you still want to live in the cubicle, you're going to die in the cubicle. So it's your choice to get out of it and find something much better than that. Basically, everybody needs to grow. So when it comes to racing, especially, you know, because I find a lot of youngsters, you know, many boys, you know, they had the dream of being a pilot or a race car driver. But trust me, many people gave up or forgot it in just a matter of a few months. They got into a job because they know that they're not going to go anywhere far. But the difference is, I never gave up on it.
You spoke about how you have your own line of salons and spas, right? Tell us about how that came about, where you see that going in the next few years.
Yeah, well, frankly speaking, I just like putting my foot into every trade, because not only salon and spa, and we're into agriculture, being in the background of training and marketing, and of course, music. I had my own DJing academy, and now, apart from racing, there's something I do newly, is that I train boys to get into racing now, so.
Congratulations. Our theme for today is I Can Do It, and I think that was one of the main reasons why you were brought in, because you epitomize the spirit of I Can Do It. Tell us what that means to you.
Well, frankly speaking, I was very much, you know, excited when I heard the theme was I Can Do It, because, you know, I've gone to many conferences and all that, but the theme really attracted me, got my attention. I said, hey, that's something which I actually do every day. I believe that I can do something. And I actually feel pity for many people who actually give up on their dreams, and I take opportunity, wherever I find an opportunity, I sit and chat with them and probably find a way they can bring out their dreams, bring it back and bring it to life again.